Well, motorists using diesel-powered vehicles, well, you better gas up. That's because local oil firms will be implementing a 1 peso and 20 centavo per liter price increase for diesel beginning Tuesday. Kerosene, on the other hand, will see a 70 centavo per liter hike. Gasoline prices will remain the same this week. Pope Francis names Filipino Bishop Pablo Virgilio David as among the Catholic Church's newest cardinals. The head of the Bishop's Conference of the Philippines will join the select group who will someday elect among themselves Pope Francis's successor. David is the third active cardinal from the Philippines to date, next to Luis Antonio Tagle, now a high-ranking Vatican official, and Manila Archbishop Jose Advincula. David is a staunch defender of human rights, with many drug war victims under the Duterte administration recorded in his diocese in Caloocan. The cardinal-elect will receive the red hat from the Pope during a December 8 ceremony at the Vatican. Hezbollah rockets hit Israel's north following another night of intense bombardment in Beirut. Reports say 10 were injured after two rockets hit Haifa, Israel's third largest city, and five others hit Tiberias. Hezbollah says it had targeted a military base south of Haifa earlier Sunday. Israel said fighter jets hit targets belonging to Hezbollah's intelligence headquarters in the Lebanese capital. The Chinese embassy in Pakistan confirms two Chinese nationals were killed in an explosion near the international airport of Karachi. 10 others were injured in the blast in what the embassy called a terrorist attack. The separatist militant group Baloch Liberation Army has claimed responsibility, saying it was an attack targeting Chinese nationals. The BLA is fighting for independence for the province of Balochistan in Pakistan's southwest. The group specifically targets Chinese interests, accusing Beijing of helping Islamabad exploit the province. Senator De La Rosa believes President Marcos is being pressured to cooperate with the ICC's probe into the drug war. Duterte's allies have repeatedly asserted the ICC has no jurisdiction to conduct the probe, citing the former president's withdrawal from the ICC. In November, Marcos said he was considering a possible return to the ICC's fold.
I have seen this a million times or a thousand times, sabi niya, or a million times, 100 times, that I'm not going to lift a finger in cooperating with the ICC. Mayroon lang mga tao nagpipressure sa kanya, siguro, nakikita ko, as I see it, na talagang gusto siyang ipa-cooperate sa ICC. So, kaya ganun na lang yung kanyang sitwasyon, no? Para lumalabas na laban bawi.
Meanwhile, self-confessed drug lord Kerwin Espinosa says he is willing to testify before the ICC. Duterte linked Espinosa and his father to the narcotics trade. The elder Espinosa turned himself in back in 2016 but was killed in detention. Human rights groups claim over 27,000 were killed during Duterte's bloody war on drugs. Well, a Duterte ally remains hopeful. Former President Duterte's son, Baste, may run for senator next year. Senator Bato de la Rosa says the Duterte's plans for the midterm elections are not yet final.
Wala pang final. Hindi ko pa alam talaga kung anong balak nila sa buong pamilya nila. Basta kami sa Pilipilaban, si Mayor Baste Duterte ay aming hinihikayat na sumama sa linya namin na maging senatorial candidate. So kung tatakbo si President Duterte as mayor, then ma-free up na si Mayor Baste, then pwede siyang mag-file ng candidacy niya for senator.